Welcome back to our Proactive London studio. I'm delighted to be joined here by Alex Scanlon, who is the Managing Director of Barton Gold. Very, very warm welcome to you, Alex. It's good to see you again. And it's been a little while since we last spoke. I think it was back in November. And since then, you've embarked on a bit of a world tour, haven't you?
I have, yeah, indeed. Yeah, in November, we were in London and then Zurich. And then we had quite a strong response to that, sort of getting out, telling our story. It's really the first time we've been able to do that post-COVID. And so this year, as we're in the lead up to not only a lot of exploration results coming out, but then sort of resource growth, we're back out meeting with people in North America and Europe again to kind of continue to share the story and then get right back into really heavy infield work for the year.
Understood. So what is it that you are bringing to all these people that you've been visiting?
On the one hand, it's an introduction to the story. Obviously, we're an Australian listed security, and having completed our IPO during COVID, we weren't able to get out, right? So there's a lot of people who are familiar with our story in Australia, but not in other markets that are very, mining interested markets. So we're obviously quite keen to take our story as an introduction to North America and to spread the awareness as well in sort of the European market. But what we have done since listing is also quite a bit of sort of development work of these assets. So before we IPO'd, we put together a 1.1 million ounce resource package. We also control the only mill in the region. So we have this very strong platform. And around that, and sort of the purpose of our IPO is to prove the geological concept that we think there's a lot of growth potential in these assets. So we've consolidated essentially an entire historical gold region. And we've now gone and found four new gold zones for over 2 kilometers of new mineralization over this past sort of 18 to 20 months. So the 2022 is really a year of sort of proof of geological concept. And 2023 is now, we anticipate having multiple resource growth updates. And so we've completed a whole bunch of drilling over the past 4 months. We've just put out our first results, which show what we think to be extensions of an existing resource. And we expect to grow the resources and potentially grow them a few more times. So it's really, in finality, getting people aware of the story so that they can actually start following our news flow as we go through. I think will be a very exciting year ahead.
Okay, so what about the highlights from that news flow, do you think? What are they going to be?
Well, a couple key things. We had a bit of fun pre-Christmas, so completely separate to the exploration front. We did a bit of a workover program of our existing mill. So we own the only gold mill in the region, as I mentioned. And we think there are opportunities to optimize the gravity side of the plant. We took down the critical infrastructure and key components. And as we were cleaning this out, we actually removed about 10 tons of gold-bearing material from the plant. So we've taken that out and we'll start processing that in parcels. So during the next sort of 6 to 8 months, we'll probably be selling gold in a few parcels just for a bit of fun. But on the exploration side, we have identified some of what we think are not only mineral extensions, but duplicate gold zones in an area below the resource that wasn't previously tested. So the resource is sort of a shear-hosted gold, where there is a footwall to the mineralization in terms of which was a mafic dike. The previous theory was that was actually the end of the mineralization. We've drilled down that and identified extensions of that mineralization. We also drilled through it and we found mineralization on the other side of the dike, and we kept going and we found entirely new gold zones there. So really a validation of that thesis. We would hope and expect that continues. We will look at mineral resource update for our 223 deposits targeting April. We also have a regional exploration target there called Area 51, kind of a funny name, but purely coincidental to the drill hole numbering. That is something that we are drilling on or have just finished drilling on. We're hoping that may actually become the start of a new mineral resource footprint. So if that data comes back during April and May favorably, there's potential that we could have another resource update during June. And then we're gonna be right back out in the field, basically following up all of this extensional work, grow the resource again by the end of the year, and really put ourselves in a position to articulate a simple message. And that is, we did the work before IPO, we IPO'd it on a thesis, we validated that thesis, we grew it again, it's gonna keep growing, so now we're gonna think about how we develop it. And then we'll just keep growing it in parallel.
Now, Alex, all of that growth and all that exploration and all that drilling comes at a financial cost, so how are you set for cash at the moment?
We're in a very good position for cash. So we re-raised $15 million at our IPO, and that is now 20 months ago. obviously, we had a plan to spend about $15 million over 24 months. Fast forward to 20 months later, we have done over 30,000 meters of drilling. We've done multiple geophysical programs. And we still, as of the 31st of December, we still had $8.85 million in cash. So that reflects one very cost-efficient exploration. But to spend only about $6 million doing all of that would be nearly impossible. What we've also done in parallel is monetize our asset package. So, you know, as we know, we have a mill. We also have extensive real estate holdings and camps and surplus equipment, things that to us are entirely surplus to our regional strategy. So we've actually been systematically monetizing these assets as well. And that has been disposals of assets. It has been pulling gold out of our mill and selling gold. We sold $1 million worth of gold last year. And as I mentioned, we expect to have more sales here. So that's allowed us to essentially offset a considerable amount of expenditure and come to a place where we still had almost $9 million at the 31st of December. Essentially, all of the corporate overhead costs of the company are covered by asset monetization. So the vast majority, if not all, of our net cash expenditure is going directly into projects and project engineering, which is a very rare thing for an explorer or developer, if you will.
Understood, Alex. Well, I've just got one final question. It's a question that I like to ask everybody that comes in here, which is, what is it that you think people don't tend to get or to understand about what it is that you're talking to them about?
Look, I think it's kind of articulating the ability to move our assets from the thought phase or the concept phase into the operations phase. It's quite unusual for a so-called explorer or developer to have the infrastructure platform that we have. Essentially, we have consolidated a region where somebody just pushed pause. We've pulled it all back together, and the opportunity for us is to, we don't have to recreate a multi-million ounce proof of concept. We already have proven logistics, proven metallurgy, proven infrastructure. We just want to make sure that we have our pathway to 150,000 ounces per annum relatively well defined. That's our five-year plan. And then we can bring forward operations using some of our higher grade resources near that mill and start essentially stage one operations. The ability for us to do that is essentially a $5 to $10 million workover program on our mill, as opposed to a $150 million development and, you know, anywhere from 1 to 3 years of permitting and studies to do that. So we have a really significant advantage moving from the thought bubble to the action bubble. And if you're interested in gold development and operations, that's really what it comes down to. And importantly, the team. You know, we have an exceptional team with a very strong South Australian and gold pedigree. Many of our team members are former Normandy Newmont personnel at very senior levels, and a lot of South Australian operational expertise. So we have the team to actually take it from thought to operations as well.
All right. Well, sounds like you've got plenty to be getting on with there, Alex. But thank you very much for your time today. And hopefully we'll catch you again soon next time you're in town.
Thank you very much.